Good evening. Thank you so much for being here tonight. It's great to see such a robust crowd. And let me tell you, you have chosen so well tonight. We are so happy that our guest this year is the incomparable Day Hall, one of jazz's most important figures. He's played with so many titans like Miles Davis, Joe Henderson, Stan Getz, Thelonious Monk, Pat Metheny. But his associations with these giants are only part of his immense contribution to this music. He's an incredible composer and leader and innovator in his own right, and we've just been so thrilled to have him here this week. His energy and his spirit with our students has been nothing short of miraculous, and he's been more than generous with his time and interest in the students. And I can't wait for this culminating event because we've just had a fantastic week. So without further ado, please welcome Mr. Day Hall.
Yeah, it's so great to see you all here. I don't know about you, but after all the stuff we went through with the lockdown and everything, these events mean so much more somehow. Coming together, you know, the communion of sharing the music in a live situation, experiencing the emotions together, it's what we can express our humanity, I think, in one of the best ways. And so it's wonderful to be here with you all. And with these wonderful musicians I've been working with this week, I've had a great time. So thank you all for coming to share. Appreciate it. I'm not going to talk too much, but I just want to say I've been really impressed by the wonderful feeling in this organization here. There's such a great community feeling. Everybody's so supportive. And I have to say the faculty did amazing job preparing these wonderful musicians for a life in music, and it's made my job a lot easier coming here and working with musicians who are ready to play. So we've had a wonderful week together, and I want to thank Andrew and all the faculty for all the work they do here too. So before we start this set, I just want to tell you a little bit about the songs. Still got the feedback here, by the way. So they're going to play three songs that I wrote, and I'll just tell you a little bit about them. Okay, the first one's called You I Love, and there's a tradition in the music of writing, taking a standard tune and writing a new melody for it. And one of the standards I've always liked to play is I Love You. So I thought I'd write this, and then I called it You I Love, actually dedicated to my wife. And I kind of try to write a melody that really kind of takes the music in a slightly different place. The second piece is called The Dream of the Elders, and the bass line from it is based on a drum pattern that I saw in a book on African music. So just to let you know, you draw your inspiration from all kinds of places. I remember being in Tunisia and hearing a musician there and hearing a rhythm cycle from that, and we're going to play that tune later in the night. So. And then the last piece is, what's the last piece? Pass It On. Yeah, Pass It On. It's kind of got a New Orleans vibe, and I wrote this as a tribute to one of the great, great drummers from New Orleans, Ed Blackwell. He was the drummer with Coleman. Yeah, let's hear it for Ed. Thank you. And the reason I called it Pass It On was that I had great fortune of playing with this master on several occasions. And we used to go to Banff in Canada and teach up there together and at the School of Fine Arts. And Ed could analyze the history of the drums from Big Sid Catlett in the early days all the way up to modern times. teacher, and he would pass on the tradition. So I call this Kim Pasito. So I hope you enjoy it. Please welcome Santa. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. the Jewish Choral Ensemble.
So just give us a moment, we'll be right with you.
Hello. Thank you. How about that band? Wow. Let's hear that. See what I'm saying about the spirit? Wow. Yeah. Anyway, we're going to get our chance to play a small group set for you now. These are three tunes that I wrote for a band that I had for almost 15 years. It was one of the great periods of my recent career. The band featured Chris Potter on tenor and Rob Newbanks on trombone, Billy Kelson on drums, Abraham Nate Smith, and then this wonderful vibraphone player, Steve Nelson, who's a real treasure. I mean, it's what an improviser that man is. Anyway, these are three tunes we did with that group on a couple of records, and the first one's called The Balance, and the second tune is called Make Believe. And that's the one that actually I was influenced by a restaurant I went to in Tunisia. I was playing with Anwar Brahim, who's a wonderful oud player. And there was a gentleman there playing a traditional instrument with hammers on it. It's like a zither that's played with hammers on it. I forget the name exactly of it. And I was fascinated by the rhythm of it that he was doing. It turned out to be a particular rhythm cycle. And I kind of used it in that song. That's tune that ended up being called Make Believe. So a bit of fantasy. And then we're going to close out with a tune that's kind of just straight ahead. Nice fast tempo tune called Cosmos. So I hope you enjoy it. Thanks so much. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please. We have a wonderful time playing with you all. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So if you're interested in more exciting events like this, we have a mailing list outside on the table. If you'd like to sign up, you can receive our emails and our semesterly mailer of all our events. So please, if you're not already on our mailing list, please sign up for that, both your email address and your snail mail address, and we'll send you some correspondence about some of our upcoming events. We have a great event coming up on Sunday, December 10th. We have jazz for the holidays. There's some posters outside. There's elves on the posters. There's going to be music from Duke Ellington and the Nutcracker. There's going to be all kinds of stuff. So please join us on Sunday, December 10th at 3 p.m. in this hall if you're interested in some jazz holiday music. And in January, we're super excited. We not only have a great instrumental program, but we have one of the greatest vocal jazz programs in the world. And we've been invited to present at the Jazz Educators Network Convention. And we're super excited. So, Greg, what day is that? January 4th? 5th. Thanks. I needed some help from my colleague Greg there. I couldn't remember if it was 4th or 5th. And we're super, super grateful that the President's Office has helped us get our ensemble and musicians down to the Jazz Educators Network event in New Orleans. It takes a lot to get that many folks down. It's a good 25 people. So we're honored to be there, and we're so thankful to the President and his office for helping us support that. Yes, could we have a round of applause? So one of our most important programs here at Western Michigan University is our Multimedia Arts Technology program. And the sound tonight is being provided by some of those students, and also Dr. Carter Rice, who is one of the most brilliant people I've ever had the privilege of knowing. He said today, I don't know that many people, but I know a lot of people, and Carter is very brilliant. So we want to extend a heartfelt thanks. They provide all of our sound throughout the semester, and it's a great learning experience for the students, and we're so blessed to have Carter to help us out tonight. So please turn around and acknowledge our Mac students and Carter Rice. We want to thank Kevin West and everyone in the concert office for their assistance with this evening, and we want to thank our director, Scott Ireland, for his support. And we also want to thank our dean, Dan Gaillette, for his ongoing support of our program and the stewardship of the entire College of Fine Arts. It's been incredible what he's done for us, and there's been some difficult times, and he's navigated those for us very, very adroitly. I want to thank all my colleagues on the jazz faculty tonight. A special thanks to Matthew Fries, who did all of our social media campaign and designed our incredible posters. Man, he's got some graphic arts jobs, doesn't he? So thank you so much for that. And there's also one individual that really needs special attention, and that's Jan Vanderclay. Jan is the one who provides us with our funding for this event, and it's considerable, and we're very, very appreciative. We could not do this without her. So if you see her walking around campus, thank her for Jazz Masters, because this is a really great event. It's great for our community, and it's great for our students. Our students get so much out of this week, I can't tell you. This is the reason I teach, because to see the look on their faces as with when someone like Dave Holland's in their presence and spreading his knowledge and wisdom. So let's all put our hands together for the great. We're going to shift gears and play some of Dave's great big band music. He has such a wide span of music, and we're really excited to play some of his large ensemble pieces. So I'll be right back. Put my saxophone on.
How y'all doing out there, okay? Yeah. Yeah, that's good, but I'm having a lot of fun. That's the prime directive, you know, have fun. If you're not having fun, you're doing something wrong. All right, so we're gonna play a program of big band music now. This is, I think most of this was featured on an album I did a few years ago called What Goes Around. And we're going to start off the program. We're going to take it to the blues. And this is a blues I wrote as a dedication to one of my big influences and incredible composer. And just an incredible bass player, too. He contributed so much to original music. And of course, talking of Charles Mingus. Let's hear it for Charles Mingus. So this first tune is called Blues for CN, and we're going to follow that with a song called Upswing, which is kind of self-explanatory. And then, as we're living in this weather that we're dealing with right now, this next tune is called First Snow. Well, I don't think it's the first snow this one, but it was welcoming me when I first arrived, so I knew it was winter now. And then we're going to finish off the set with a tune called Shadow Dance. Hope you enjoy. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Holland. Dan Holland.